Over the last 10 months, we've made it a priority to shed light on how the opioid epidemic is impacting Idaho. Every single Monday night, we've introduced you to a person or a place pushing for change. And change has happened, from recovery to new programs to new state funding. We continue to find hope.
Recovery happens. It's possible. I just celebrated 14 years last week in recovery myself.
Along the way, over the last 10 months, one of the most important things we've learned at Six on Your Side is recovery is worth celebrating.
Recovery is so amazing, and I'm not just talking about just being clean, but living that positive life.
From single moms and future moms to Idaho veterans and everything in between.
It is a disease, you know, and there's little triggers that happen every day. Good things make you want to use, bad things. It never goes away.
Almost all we've talked to started out with prescription pills.
It starts out slow, you know, just a few here and there, and then all of a sudden I'm taking five at a time.
And they kept increasing it. I was taking 90 milligrams of morphine. Three times a day.
It's a problem plaguing police across the state, now seeing illegal drugs trafficked into our communities from across state lines.
Every single day, somebody's tripping to Utah and bringing back heroin.
We can see anywhere from users to have the tiniest amounts to the traffickers that have ounces, you know, and up to pounds of it.
Many users start out by treating chronic pain, eventually developing a dependence, opening up to share their road to recovery with us. Mark Deba is living opioid free after weaning himself off prescription pills by using acupuncture.
It seemed to like unblock those issues that I was having throughout my body. I could literally feel from my toes to my kneecap something tingling in between. And I could feel after the treatment was done, I had no more pain in that area.
Meanwhile, Jerry Cush made the move to Oregon to legally medicate his chronic pain with pot.
Basically, marijuana has been the best for me all along.
But with the recent increased awareness around addiction comes extra measures to stop overprescribing and efforts to keep opioids out of the hands of those who don't need them. We introduced you to the Nampa oral surgeon using an opioid alternative to send some of his patients home post-surgery, prescription pill free.
Honestly, I didn't feel any pain the whole time, so that was really, really nice.
In Garden City, veterinarians at West Vet are taking prescribing precautions to prevent addicted pet owners from playing the system to get pills for themselves.
And so we try to be very cautious with the amount of opioids we send home, and try to be very careful about refills and how much are sent out the door.
So what else has been done since we started our Finding Hope coverage? The city of Boise enacted a three-year opioid crisis response strategic plan and even joined a federal lawsuit against major opioid manufacturers and distributors. Idaho Representative Mike Simpson signed on to be a co-sponsor of a bill, which is now law, allowing hospice workers to destroy unneeded medications after a patient's death. The Boise Police Department and Idaho Department of Correction have started pilot programs aimed at keeping offenders out of jail and in treatment. Plus, Idaho lawmakers provided legal protections to those who call 911 while witnessing or experiencing an opioid overdose, all in an effort to save lives in Idaho.
I'm really hoping that we're going to start seeing kind of a reduction in these.
So, what have we learned about what it takes to reach recovery? The more peer support people receive, the better their odds are at overcoming opioid addiction.
I want to infect as many people as possible with as much hope as I can, because if they can find hope, then they can find their way.
And we're not alone in this fight against opioids. It's a nationwide epidemic. So tomorrow we're hitting the road and heading to Salt Lake City, Utah, a metro community only about 5 hours from Boise, with deep ties to our area. And as you'll see, the drugs coming into our state. We'll show you the success Utah has made in public safety, recovery, and reducing deaths in just 3 years, giving Idaho a new place to tap into ideas to find new hope.